Everybody okay, Matt?
All right, now we can start. Thank you very much. Welcome to the Falls Township Board of Supervisors meeting, April 17th, 2012. We'll begin our meeting, as we always do, with a salute to the flag, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mrs. Pullen, can you call the roll, please?
Mr. Galloway?
Here.
Mr. Sykes?
Here.
Mr. Harvey?
Here.
Mr. Dents?
Mr. Rocco? Here.
Okay, at the record show, Mr. Dents is home ill, so he was not able to make it this evening. Okay. I want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. We're starting out with something that we're honored to do. For some of our residents who have done, sort of gone above and beyond on their own to help out their neighbors and their community. As many people know, a few weeks ago there was a tragic fire in the Elderberry section of Lovettown that resulted in the deaths of two of our residents. Out of that tragedy, there were seven members of our community who are here with us this evening. Who really took it upon themselves to do a good deed and go around their neighborhood and raise money for that family to help them offset their costs and also to contribute some of that money to Lovettown Fire Company, which responded to that call. Thanks to Chief Rich Van Squeak and also Rich Hoagland from the Lovettown Fire Company bringing this, kind of this to our attention. They raised the idea that we should, kind of do something to honor these young people, which is, a perfect idea, and we're something we're very, very happy to do. And so we're going to be passing proclamations this evening, honoring these seven young people for all of their efforts and for this incredible good deed. And the seven proclamations are identical, obviously, except for the names. And so I'm going to begin just by reading the names, and then I'll read one of the proclamations just so everybody has an idea of what they say. The young people we have with us this evening, Madigan McGrath, Molly McGrath, Haley Allard, Alyssa Stewart, Amerigo Amadai, Dason Amadai, and Dalton Harmon. Okay, and I'll just read one of these. Falls Township Board of Supervisors Proclamation, Acknowledgement of Dalton Harmon, April 2012. Whereas the Township of Falls is a second-class township located in the County of Bucks in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and whereas the Board of Supervisors, which is the duly elected governing body of the Township of Falls, recognizes the importance of acknowledging individuals who make valuable contributions to the lives of the citizens of Falls Township, and whereas Mr. Dalton Harmon of Falls Township has distinguished himself and improved his community through his efforts to raise funds for the McCardle family. Now, therefore, be it resolved, the Board of Supervisors of the Township of Falls, on behalf of the citizens of Falls Township, expresses its sincere admiration and gratitude to Mr. Harmon and does hereby issue this proclamation honoring Mr. Dalton Harmon for his commitment to assist the McCardle family in their time of need and for doing so without expectation of any reward or recognition other than the knowledge that his actions were the right thing to do. Proclaimed the 17th day of April 2012 by the Falls Township Board of Supervisors. So with that, I'll invite other board members to make comments, and after those comments, I'll entertain a motion to approve these proclamations as a whole en masse, and then we can make the presentation to these to our young people down here. Right. Mr. Galloway?
I'd just like to say that I'm proud to have these young people as members of our community. And I think you did a wonderful thing. Thank you.
Snipes?
Yes, sometimes it's the young people, sometimes the children, the kids that have to show adults what the right thing to do is. And so I really want to thank you guys for what you did. You're a great example for the adults and for everybody in the community. So we're really, really thrilled to have you here tonight. And I'm looking forward to seeing you get your proclamations. I hope there's someone here to take pictures. Yes? Excellent. Okay, that's great. Thank you.
Mr. Rocco?
Yeah, I just want to say that I'm very proud of you guys. I think it's amazing what you've done. You turned a tragedy, something positive out of this tragedy, and it's something to be proud of. So thank you.
Okay. And I believe, before we go ahead and vote on this, I believe one of the young ladies involved has something she'd like to say. And you can take, there's a microphone right there. You can actually pull it out if you want to.
My friends and I collected $1,124 for a plaque at the library in honor of David, because that's where he liked to go. Flowers for David's funeral, Levittown No. 1 Fire Company, and the rest went to David's mom and aunt. We stood out front of my friend Melissa's house holding up a sign that said, "Accepting donations for fire victims." We got a lot of money from the neighbors and people driving by to see the house. We all knew David and Jack very well, and they were both very nice.
David always used to say hi and play with us, and Jack was very nice to David and his neighbors. We will miss them. Thank you.
Thank you very much. With that, I don't think I'll have much trouble finding somebody to make a motion to approve these proclamations.
So moved.
Second.
Very well. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Okay. We're going to come down there and distribute these. All right. Certainly, Mr. Rocco did a very good job in saying it's a great way to start off a meeting, but, you know, obviously it comes out of something that was tragic. So we thank these, you know, obviously the children, but also it's clear to us and anybody that, you know, thinks about this issue that the children would not have been doing this kind of act if they didn't have the parents that they have. And so obviously the children are a reflection of the kind of parenting that makes situations like this possible. So we thank them as well for being here, and you know, and certainly you've earned everything you've got so far, all the praise, all the, you know, the certificates you have in front of you, the proclamations, the attention you're getting. You've deserved it. You've earned it. And thank you again very much for everything you did. It's really, you know, very, very admirable. Okay. Yeah. So, let's see. With that, we're changing our order a little bit. We talked last meeting about the idea of changing the order of our meetings, starting out with public comment. Thank you. Just to be clear as well, there are some townships and some municipalities and some school boards where you speak at the first part of the meeting, and then you're not permitted to speak on anything the rest of the meeting. That is not what we're doing here. This is any kind of general public comment. You're encouraged to speak. If there's something specific on the agenda you want to speak on, when that issue comes up, you'll be you know, able to speak on that just like we have in the past. Okay. That being said, if you know, if what you want to speak about is something that's on the agenda, we'd ask you to wait until that agenda item comes up, and then just speak on it at that time. This is more for general comment about things in the township or issues in the past or something in the future. Okay. So we'll start with our public comment. First name on the list is Roland Kenny.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, Roland Kenny, Falls Township. I'd like to start off first with a moment of silence. In the last couple of months, we lost an awful lot of people. Quite a few firefighters lost their lives. People in our township lost their lives. And if, which you're okay, I'd like
Certainly.
To have a moment of silence.
Certainly.
Thank you. First, I think I will thank you for bringing this first. I've been asking for it the last year or so. I'm glad. I think it's the right thing to do. Second, I want to thank you for getting the shed down at Three Arches. I seen it last week. It's a nice looking shed. Any word on we had Mr. Fitzpatrick at the senior center last week. He's talking something about the senior center. Any word on when it might start?
We are continuing to
still fighting with them.
Jump through the hoops the county has asked us to jump through. It's what the kind of the game we have to play in order to get the funding. So we're continuing to do that and do that environmental study and just make sure that everything, all the I's are dotted, T's are crossed. And I don't know if there is some kind of timeline, Mr. Sullivan, regarding it, you know, whether we're talking weeks or months or...
We're talking weeks at this point, but it's, you know...
All right, that's what I want to hear. That's what I want to hear you say, because I told them it was going to happen before May, and I hope it does.
Well, it might be...
No. Weeks would be more like, you know, six
no,
weeks
I said
or so.
July.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. July, yes. I'm sure we can get started before then.
Thought I'd give you a month or so.
Thank you.
And there was a fire yesterday. Or what was it? Yesterday? Yeah. Or no, Sunday. And another propane tank. Fled the flames. You have a propane tank, keep it away from your house. Keep it off your porch. Keep it furthest way you can get it away from your house, because you never know when you leave that valve on. You leave that valve on, anything can happen. And I'm saying this mainly for Admiral, because their houses there are four together. One goes up, you're liable to get all four go up. So just want everybody be aware of what can happen. And I just before I came here, I was watching TV, Mayor Nutter. I was going to talk about the dirt bag from New York. They keep on coming down here. Like he said, he didn't know how to get in touch with the city when he was getting calls on about the building, but he sure knew how when they sent a little letter about what he got himself a lawyer ASAP. This is what happens. I think it should be laws like in our township, and we have I would imagine we have people here from New York owning a lot of these big properties. You warn them the first month, you fine them the second month real heavy, and they don't pay it, take it away from them. Make them pay everything and take the building away, tear it down or do something with it, because we're losing too many lives and it's ridiculous. That's all I got. God bless you. Good night.
Thank you. Yeah, and just kind of hitting on that, just to, while you're talking about fire safety, I know that the newspaper, I think, ran a story talking to Fire Marshal DiPolito, that people that don't have fire alarm or smoke detectors in their homes can contact his office. Even if you do, if you have one, especially people that are elderly, they can't, maybe it's on the ceiling, you can't get to it to change the battery, call the fire marshal's office, call your local fire department, or just, you know, stop one of them if you see one of them, and, you know, because, you know, obviously they're all local. You see them in church, you see them in the supermarket, and let them know that you need somebody to help you change a battery. They'll be more than happy to help you out. You know, certainly they'd rather do that than you know, suffer some kind of tragedy because of a smoke detector that didn't work, which unfortunately was the case in the fire in Elderbury. So, but thank you, Mr. Kinney, for raising those issues. Madeline Jones?
Hello, good evening. Madeline Jones, Falls Township. Just briefly, we're about to celebrate Earth Day. And hopefully our children and ourselves and within the community are aware what it's all about and not just that one day. Recently, my eyes fell upon a poster. Protect our forest friends. Protect our forest friends. And I could not read the fine print to figure out what I was relating to. Sometimes we forget to protect ourselves, okay? We're supposed to have dominion over our forest friends, and sometimes we have more importance placed on the creatures, our pets, etc. Protect our forest friends is important, because what we're doing today with the noise environment and the lighting environment, we're killing or harming at the creatures and the earth and in the trees. I mentioned years ago, at my house years ago, I could walk around and read a newspaper fine print because of the lighting, okay? And I just found out firsthand recently that a local resident, streets away, a light was placed, a bulb was replaced, and this local resident can now, across the room, literally, and this is true, read the title of a book on the binder. Now you figure that out. How bright is that light two streets away that goes through all that property? It's got to be under consideration. What are we doing? Someone said to me today, well, we have so much crime that a whole world basically is now lit up at night. These children are the future. And like you said, their parents are responsible too for what they have done. We need more of our children and adults in this community and throughout our country internationally. Our skies at night were made to be darkened at night. I've come down route, bypass Route 1 on the curves at night. The white lights on the graded roads, they're blinding, absolutely blinding. It makes no sense. Makes no sense. We need nighttime for the creatures, the birds, and the trees. We need it for our own hearts, minds, body, and souls. The noise, I don't know, my time's probably running out. There is an art, there's so much to talk about. There is an article, I didn't bring it in. The Right to Quiet Society. I belong to that for years. There's another one, you type in noise pollution. You could type in light pollution. I did talk on this years ago and brought readings in. Noise pollution, their spring newsletter talks about the noise is harming the plants and the trees, etc. Okay, someone knew I was coming to speak shortly and I had to get myself here. Earth Day, okay. Everybody at home in here, hopefully make a note, I believe, because I left everything in the car. April 24th, International Noise Awareness Day. 2:15, everyone is asked to pause for a moment of silence to listen to the soundscape. Okay, and again, you'll probably find that as you type in noise pollution. Someone found out that I was coming eventually, and they asked me, please stand up and say something about the township is spending too much money. Okay, too much money. And this person's been around a while. When I've listened to Biles Island, and I have not been able to get here, I left work early to get here tonight. Restaurant, we do not need, please, no restaurant, no commercial building should be permitted on that island. When we first went on that tour, a lot of us agreed. I think one person who was kind of new involved in this, he had this whole big, you know, commercial stuff. It's ridiculous. You're gonna have concrete, you're gonna have oils, you're gonna have everything harmful to natural nature, you know, this area environment. There's no reason for a restaurant down there. Thank you always and enjoy the season. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, those are the only names on the list. Anyone else wish to speak? No? Okay. All right, second item on our agenda is to consider final plan of minor subdivision for General Office Area South tax map parcel number 1351-5. This is a subdivision on U.S. Steel property inside the KOIZ, or KIPC, excuse me. Mr. Gray?
Yes. As mentioned, this is consideration for final plan of minor subdivision for General Office South Area. Tonight, representing the applicant is Ms. Kelly McGowan.
Good evening. How are you this evening?
Good evening. Fine.
It's difficult to follow the children.
Yes. That's fine. Yeah, just make sure you use the microphone so we can get you on the record.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Kelly McGowan, representing U.S. Steel Corporation. As you noted, this is an application, a minor subdivision application, seeking final approval tonight for the subdivision of the piece of property that is located generally at the intersection of Sorrels Boulevard and Roebling Road in the KIPC. It's generally in the middle of the KIPC. The proposal is to subdivide approximately 38 acres from the over 1,400 acre tract. No construction is proposed at this time. It's a strict minor subdivision. The sewer and water service to the site is already provided, and that's provided by U.S. Steel. The intent, as I'm sure you're aware, is to facilitate a land development, which we hope will happen soon by the Steel Orca Corporation. Steel Orca is a data processing, a very high-tech data processing business. So we have a Bucks County Planning Commission letter from April the 2nd. Bucks County Planning Commission raises no technical issues, no zoning issues. They simply cite to the waivers that we've requested. TNM issued a review letter on April 12th, 2012, based upon revised plans that we did subsequent to the initial review letter and to the Planning Commission. The TNM review letter also cites to the waivers that we requested and then has two general comments. To speak generally with respect to the waivers, because this is a strict minor subdivision and there's no construction proposed, it's actually our position that a lot of these sections are not applicable. With that said, we requested the waiver in deference to the land development process. I can go through, Mr. Chairman, those waiver requests for you if you would like in detail.
Now, the board members have the resolution. I'm assuming you have the proposed resolution as well, Ms.
I do.
Ms. McGowan.
Mm-hmm.
So essentially, what we're looking at is waiving some of the issues in terms of providing adequate right-of-way, street trees, natural resources, existing curbs being put in, character and location of building of soils, buildings, species of trees, water and sewer certification, and surface drainage. You know, Mr. Sullivan, in terms of these are all essentially issues that are going to come up with any kind of land development, and obviously without meeting these or getting waivers from these later on, no development can really happen. Is that correct?
That's essentially correct, yes.
Okay. All right. So is there any issue with waiving these this evening?
I have no issues with the waivers.
Okay. All right.
The same sections of the ordinance are going to be applicable to the land development process. Yes.
Okay. All right. So comments or questions from board members? We're looking at seven specific waivers on here listed. Comments or questions, Mr. Galloway?
No comment.
Mr. Snipes?
Wasn't there another requested waiver, not just about street? I mean, not the issues related to potential development, but to township access?
I think there was an issue raised. There's a general comment on page 4 of the ordinance asking that Falls Township be listed as having access rights to 100-foot utility drainage easement. I know some discussion back and forth between the applicant and the township, and I think the view of this of the solicitor, the engineer, and at least myself and a couple of the board members is that should stay for present time. I think that's your understanding as well.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, if I can speak to that. In discussions, it was my request that we actually do this in a separate note, and that the note will reference the drainage easement specifically. As I understand from Mr. Sullivan, the concern is the stormwater management facilities. And then the only thing that I would request is that there be some language put in there that would provide for modifications during the land development process of what's shown there, depending upon what the user desires to do in their stormwater management plan. Of course, at that time, the township will require a stormwater management plan and then a maintenance agreement, you know, along those lines, and your concerns will be satisfied at that time.
But any preliminary plan they would do, whoever's going to purchase it would have to include such an easement anyway.
That's correct.
Is that correct?
Yeah, the township, you would require that, correct, during the land development.
So
what Ms. McGowan is suggesting with regards to this, I understand the decision to want this left into the minor subdivision, but I think what she is suggesting about any land development plans is accurate. There will need to be easements that will be addressed, and they may need to be modified based upon the actual plan that is submitted.
Okay.
Right.
And they have agreed to add a note to this plan about the easement, giving us access to that area if we need it at this time, and that will be modified when the land development process comes through. The easement will then be from Steel Urca.
Okay.
And I think that's all essentially Ms. McGowan is saying, is that land development will end up modifying this blanket easement with a more specific easement as we move forward through the land development process. Right. So we don't have a problem with that.
All right. So that's, well, just adding that on to that general comment number one, just adding that little piece that subsequent land development was that what you're proposing, or is that what you're?
I said, you know, we will work with Jim and with the solicitor on language.
Have to be
sure.
In this. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Mr. Snipes, any other comments or questions?
No, that's it, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Mr. Rocco?
I have none.
Okay. Any public comment needed?
Yes.
Okay, it's a subdivision essentially cutting away this piece so that it presumably can be sold to Steel Urca as they come in and start doing development. All right, so Had some board comment, public comment. This would be resolution 12 dash
10.
10. Okay. And it would be granting the waivers mentioned earlier. Is there a motion to approve resolution 12 dash 10?
So moved, Mr. Chairman. Seconding.
Motion is made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Thank you.
Thank you very much for your time.
Okay. All right, next item on the agenda is to consider a contract agreement between Tier 1 K-9 and Falls Township. Mr. Gray?
Yes. This is a K-9 purchase agreement, as you mentioned, with Tier 1 K-9 Incorporated, located in Ontario and Falls Township. This is for the purchase of a Belgian Malinois to be used in the police department. Total cost is $24,534. This includes the purchase of the K-9, the handler course, and the K-9 equipment. The board is asked to consider this agreement. Representing the police department tonight is Lieutenant Hank Ward.
Good evening.
Good evening, Lieutenant.
What we're asking for is to replace Dante, who passed away last year. We had selected a handler. This is the same group of people that we've purchased our other dogs off of. We were able to secure a grant from the casino grant monies, and we'll be paying for it with that if you approve the contract.
Okay. All right, thank you. Comments or questions from board members? Mr. Galloway?
No comment.
Mr. Snipes?
No. I think we should move ahead.
Mr. Rocco?
I have none.
Okay. Let's see. And I know we've lost, I guess, two dogs in a way. Is Dante and also
Jessie's still serving, but she's going to be 12 aging this year.
Yeah.
That's why we're going back with these people. They're still guaranteeing our dogs. They're still training them, and we've got so much life out of them. The average police dog's going between 6 and 7 years, and we're well past that.
Okay. All right. And how long is the training for a handler?
The handler course will be 6 weeks. The dog's already trained. What we're doing is, traditionally, if we went the traditional route where we would go to Philadelphia or another police department that trains dogs, you're talking 27 weeks, we would lose an officer. This, we're only losing an officer for 6 weeks. The dog's already trained. We're basically training the handler to the dog, and it saves us a lot of time and a lot of money. It, on its face, I know it's a lot of money, but we're actually saving about $15,000 or $16,000 with salary and backfilling.
All right. Okay. All right. Any public comment needed? See no hands. All right, so we're looking then at a total a purchase agreement with Tier 1 K-9 in the amount of $24,534. Okay. So is there a motion to approve the purchase agreement with Tier 1 K-9?
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Second.
Okay, motion is made and seconded. Mrs. Pullen?
Mr. Galloway?
Yes.
Mr. Snipes?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mr. Rocco?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Have a good night.
You too. Okay, next item on the agenda is consider bids for chlorine and muriatic acid at the Pinewood Pool. Mr. Gray?
Yes, last week, Township representatives opened sealed bids for chlorine and muriatic acid for the Pinewood Pool season for 2012. The results were two companies. One was Buckman's. Chlorine was $2.15. Muriatic acid was $3.50. The second company was Chemical Equipment Labs. Chlorine was $1.89, and that's per gallon, and also muriatic acid was $4. Based on the bid results, Chemical Equipment Labs is the lowest responsible bidder. It is recommended the Board of Supervisors award the contract to Chemical Equipment Labs for chlorine and muriatic acid for the Pinewood Pool for 2012.
Okay. All right. And talking with Mr. Gray, the two chemicals, it appears that, you know, the companies come in at lower. One company was lower on chlorine, one company was lower on muriatic acid. Based on the fact that we purchase 7,800 gallons of chlorine and only muriatic acid when we need to, the idea is to go with the lower bidder on that particular item, since that's obviously the biggest quantity we buy, or the chemical we buy the biggest quantity of. Comments or questions from board members? Mr. Galloway.
No questions.
Mr. Snipes?
Yes, Mr. Gray, you feel comfortable recommending the chemical equipment lab? We have some...
We did references on the...
References that were a little less than exciting.
Two were acceptable, one was okay, another one was questionable. I think we'd be okay with this company.
Okay. Just you.
Mr. Rocco?
I have none.
Okay. And Mr. Dents, being heavily involved with the Penn First Swim Club, this is usually his strength and understanding a little bit about this. But there were, as Mr. Snipes said, there were some less than stellar, or one definitely less than stellar reference for this company, a company we have not used before, correct?
That's correct.
I know we used Buckman's for a while. I don't know who we used before that. I think just even today, today, Quakertown Borough, we received a message from them, and their experience has been positive?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay. Okay. All right, so comments or questions from the public? See none?
Public has left.
Yeah, public has left. All right, is there a motion then to award the bids for chlorine and muriatic acid for the Pinewood Pool year 2012 to Chemical Equipment Labs?
So moved.
Seconding.
Okay, Mrs. Pullen?
Mr. Galloway?
Yes.
Mr. Snakes?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mr. Rocket?
Yes.
All right. Okay, moving right along. The minutes, we're looking at two sets of minutes, one from March 20th, one from April 3rd. We'll take them one at a time here. Comments or questions regarding the March 20 minutes? Any corrections, additions? Mr. Galloway?
I don't see any corrections.
Okay. Mr. Snipes?
No, Mr. Chairman. Excellent minutes once again.
Mr. Rocco?
No, they were good. They're good.
Okay. Let's do any comments or questions regarding the April 3rd minutes. Mr. Galloway?
None.
Mr. Snipes?
No, these were excellent as well.
Mr. Rocco, you weren't here for that meeting. But,
One comment. Item number one seemed like it was probably an exciting agenda item in reading the notes. So.
Yes. All right, we'll vote on these separately here, Mr. Rocco being absent from the one meeting. Motion to approve the minutes as presented for March 20th, 2012.
So moved.
Seconding.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion to accept the minutes as presented for April 3rd, 2012.
So moved.
Seconded.
All in favor?
Aye.
Abstain.
Opposed? Abstentions. Okay. All right. Engineers report. I'm number six. Mr. Sullivan, anything you'd like to add in here?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Construction on the Quaker Penn Park Babe Ruth baseball field is scheduled to be completed mid-May. So it's another 4 weeks or so, and that'll be done. The outfield has been graded and finished, has been topsoiled and seeded. The infield is completed with sod. We're waiting on the infield mix and the warning track mix. That's a special item that we're getting from some kind of pro baseball people, which is a good thing. That'll go in, and then the fence will go up, and the project should be complete, like I said, middle of May. The 2011 road program is moving along. Curbs and sidewalks are being installed on Allendale, Winding Way, and Vernon Road. And the first road that will be reconstructed completely is Vernon. So that should happen in the next week or two. That'll start, and that'll be very disruptive to the residents at that point. But it shouldn't take them too long to get that done and under what we call binder so they can continue to drive on the road.
Okay. All right. Comments or questions for Mr. Sullivan regarding any of the engineering projects or issues? Mr. Galloway?
No questions.
Mr. Snipes?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Rocco?
Yeah, I just had one on the baseball field. Is there irrigation or water available for that field?
There's no irrigation. There is water available. It's being watered by the contract at this point. We didn't add irrigation because it's very expensive, but there is a water source that Public Works can water the field as necessary.
Right. And the other item was the culvert analysis in North Park. Can you speak to that?
The culvert analysis?
Yeah.
We've had a couple of issues raised by residents in that area. The stream channel that runs through there, it's called a tributary to Martin's Creek. doesn't flow very well. It's been, over the years, it's been silted up, had a lot of problems with maintenance. What we're doing is surveying to determine which way the water's supposed to be flowing, because it's not easy to tell just by looking at it.
Really?
And see what we can do about cleaning that up, making it work better, what kind of DEP permits we might need.
Okay, yeah, because I know a few meetings ago that was a pretty big issue. So thank you. That's all I had.
Okay. And just, if you could, just for people that are, obviously South Olds Boulevard is a road that's pretty heavily traveled, and you had the issue there with the bridge over the creek there. What's the state of that project?
Status is, I believe we finished our survey. We will be involved with a precast bridge company to design the bridge that we're going to put in for there. And the idea is to be ready to do that in July and August when school is out. So we'll be less disruptive to school traffic. But when the ridge is being installed, of course, that road will be closed.
Okay. All right. Okay. Those are all the issues that we had. All right. Is there a motion to accept the engineer's report? Back to the beginning
April
here.
April 12th, 2012.
Yeah, dated April 12th, 2012. This is the March engineering report from Mr. Sullivan. Is there a motion to accept?
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Seconded.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. The bill list, next item on our agenda. We're looking. Bill list this month, $1,798,758.34. Of that, approximately $737,000 is payroll. Another $219,000 is for health insurance. So we're looking at close to $1 million just in payroll and health insurance. The remaining $700,000, a lot of that, much of that is going to some of the projects we've already heard about, the road program, the baseball field, I believe about $20,000 to fuel. Saw another larger total for some equipment and things that we purchased. I think it was the chipper. It was a chipper we bought for chipper, I think, yes. About $24,000. And a lot of the others are things, for example, portable toilets at the park, $3,000. Tires for police and other vehicles, $3,000. Equipment for various, the fleet of vehicles we have here runs into obviously a lot of money. Comments or questions regarding the bill list? Mr. Galloway?
No questions.
Mr. Snipes?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Rocco?
I have none.
Okay, is there a motion then to approve the bills as presented, $1,798,758.34?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Sorry. Wait, I'm sorry. I have to do a roll call for that. I forget. We spend money, we have to do a roll call.
Yes.
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 Mrs. Poland is having less and less to do. I don't want to take everything away from her. All right. We don't have any for an executive session. Manager comment, Mr. Gray?
Yes, thank you. Just a few items tonight. My first item, the township received a letter from Mr. Vitor Vicente, dated April 2nd. He's from the County of Bucks Department of Community Business Development. The county has a Community Development Advisory Board to assist the county commissioners with the review and funding of projects using Community Development Block Grant funding. The Bucks County CDBG Advisory Board bylaws outline the composition of the CDBG Advisory Board. All members of the board are appointed for 2 years, with nominations and appointments occurring in even years. The county is requesting that Falls Township select a CDBG board appointment for the 2012-2013 term by Friday, May 11, 2012. The board is asked to consider nominating appointment for this advisory.
Okay. And typically the manager for the township always serves in the capacity. That's been true since, I think, before you became manager. Is that correct?
I served also as a finance director.
As a finance director. Okay. So it's been your job for a while, huh?
Since 2000.
Since 2000. Okay. All right. I'm assuming it's something you want to do, or you can always nominate somebody else to do it, I guess,
absolutely.
If you want to do. Yeah. All right. So Mr. Gray would be our representative. Any issues or comments or questions from board members for this?
No question.
No.
I guess I'd be interested to see what issues you anticipate might be taken up by the advisory board.
Each year, for instance, we have a three-year cycle that's coming up, and there's X amount of dollars that's allocated for each municipality in that three-year period. Money becomes available each year for a project to be completed, and money comes from HUD, and it filters down to the county and further down to the township. Township puts together a application for a project based on certain criteria that are required to meet the guidelines. We have to prepare an application, have a public hearing, have a resolution, and submit all the information by the end of September of each year. The county board committee for to the county commissioners. In normal years, the would become available first year, but I think the first project that we applied for, it did take a longer amount, and we're still waiting at this time. But that's pretty much the process. The money becomes available, we spend the money on the project, and we get reimbursement by the county. And they pay the bills directly. So it helps out the township with various projects.
This is projects for low and moderate income persons and areas?
We've done historical projects in the past. We've also done we've done a water sewer project. We did a road program. We did the Three Arches, Fallsington Library. So we've done a wide variety of projects.
Thank you.
Okay. All right, is there a motion then to appoint Mr. Gray as the representative for Falls Township to the CDBG?
So moved.
Excuse me, Community Development Advisory Board. Motion made. Is there a second?
I'll second it.
All right, motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
My next item, the township received a letter from Mr. Jim Sullivan, dated April 2nd, from TNM Associates regarding escrow release number 5 for AE Polysilicon. TNM is recommending a release of the escrow amount number 5 in the amount of $145,963.51. The board is asked to consider this escrow release to AE Polysilicon.
Okay. Comments or questions from board members? Straightforward. The project's complete. Well, different phases of it are complete. If no comments or questions, is there a motion to release escrow release number 5, AE Polysilicon, $145,963.51?
So moved.
Seconded.
Motion made and seconded. Mrs. Pullen?
Mr. Galloway?
Yes.
Mr. Snipes?
Yes.
Mr. Bergen?
Yes.
Mr. Rocco?
Yes.
Just a few announcements from the Park and Rec Department. The annual combined Earth Day and Arbor Day event will be held on Sunday, April 22nd at the Falls Township Community Park Phase 2 Pavilion from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. The Park and Recs Department is looking to hire lifeguards for the upcoming season at the Pinewood Pool. Any questions, comments, or any other items, please contact the Park and Rec Department for anything at 215-949-9000, extension 220. And finally, Mylars are ready for signature for CNG fueling. And that's everything I have. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Let's go to board comment now. I'll start off with this meeting. A few weeks ago, or I guess a couple meetings ago, we had some residents here from the Hedgerow Woods section of Falls who were very concerned about a housing development that was going on in Lower Makefield that borders Falls, backs up to specifically the Hilltop Road in the Hedgerow section. Mr. Snipes and I did go to a Lower Makefield Board of Supervisors meeting last month, I guess it was in March, and found that they were very interested in cooperating with Falls, very concerned about the issues of drainage that this new development might cause in an area that already has some issues with drainage. Their board was very interested in having their township engineer work with the developer's engineer and Mr. Sullivan, our engineer, to see if they could come up with a solution. Mr. Sullivan did meet with those gentlemen, and they have come up with a plan that they are very satisfied with in terms of doing almost anything that you can to fight any future drainage problem and hopefully even alleviate some of the present drainage problem. I know the Lower Makefield Board meets tomorrow night, and so I'm going to be going to that meeting just to thank them for their cooperation and their interest in helping the people of Falls Township, and also to let them know that if it's okay with the board, to let them know that with the recommendation of our engineer, we're satisfied with the modifications made to their plan, of this developer's plan, and that we feel that it's the best that can be done to alleviate the problems of drainage along Hilltop. That's okay for, you know?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes, thank you, Bob.
Okay.
Is there a chance for the board to see these changes on a plan? Is that available for us?
It is available, and I can get that for you.
Thank you.
Okay. And I think that was all. So I had actually thanks again to especially the children, obviously, for the hard work that they put in. The children we honored earlier here this evening. It really is kind of heartwarming to see kids, it was very young, as you could see, taking on such responsibilities and doing it because they knew it was the right thing to do. It was very impressive, and obviously thanks to their parents for bringing them here and for obviously instilling in them, those kinds of values. And thanks to the Levittown Fire Company for bringing this issue to our attention, and more than happy to cooperate with them and honoring these kids for doing such a great deed. We'll go to Mr. Rocco.
Okay, thank you. Just a reminder, Election Day is Tuesday, April 24th. So, as always, try to get out and vote. Also, I wanted to thank all the volunteers of the local baseball leagues this Saturday. This past Saturday was opening day. I know it was for Levittown Continental, Levittown American, and Fairless Hills. I'm not sure about PA. Was Pensbury opening day as well?
No, I believe that was several weeks ago.
In any event, I know a lot of hard work goes into that, so I just wanted to thank them guys. So that's all I had.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Snipes?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I want to echo what you said about the young children, the young folks that we heard tonight. It's inspiring to see children that young decide to take this up and to do something about it. And I also had a very sad situation myself this past week, and I wanted to thank the Falls Township Police Department for helping us out. We had a friend of ours and a tenant who passed away very suddenly, and so a number of us were in a very difficult situation trying to reach his family, calling the ambulance, then realizing that the ambulance was no longer needed. He'd already passed away. And I just wanted to say that the professionalism and the caring and sensitivity of the police that arrived and also the Bucks County coroner was very much appreciated by people who were grieving his loss and then just trying to figure out what to do in that kind of situation. So I really felt like the Falls Police Department is well-trained, not just technically in what to do, but also reaching out to people that are in a difficult situation, helping them kind of navigate their way, even a little bit emotionally, through a difficult situation, but certainly helping us to figure out who we should call and where to look for information. So I wanted to thank them very much for doing that, and I'm sure they've done it for many other people. It's not an easy position to be in. It made me think that this is the kind of thing that they must see with some frequency, and it's hard to deal with, but they were efficient and respectful and helpful in a time when they're dealing with someone's death and grieving people. So I wanted to officially thank everyone really in the police department, because I know they all work together as a team. So thank you.
Okay. Mr. Galloway.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, while it's always a pleasure to serve the township and come here to the meetings, it was a special joy tonight to see those children be honored for helping the fire victims. So that made my evening.
And I actually just remembered one other thing I wanted to announce. This year, for those that maybe don't know, is the 60th anniversary of Levittown, the construction of Levittown here in Bucks County. 60 years, not since the first house went up, but 60 years since the first family moved in, 1952. And so June 23rd and 24th, there's going to be a celebration located at Bolton Mansion. in honor of the 60th anniversary of Levittown. And there are people who are deeply involved in preserving some of the history involved in this. In fact, a crew from the BBC, the British Broadcasting Company, which is doing a special on Levittown, the construction of Levittown, is actually going to be there. They're looking for anybody who wants to be involved. Especially, they'd like to do some interviews with people who've, original Levittowners, people that moved in 60 years ago who might still be in the area, even if they don't necessarily live in the house that they purchased 60 years ago, to get some of that oral history and preserve it, for the future. And I was at a conference earlier today where we're discussing the history of Levittown, sponsored by the Lower Bucks Chamber of Commerce. Organized by Mr. Snipes' sister and attended by Mr. Snipes' father, who, of course, has a lot of knowledge about the founding of Levittown and some of the issues that were involved in the creation of the community as well as the integration of it back in the 1950s. And it was really interesting for me, knowing some of the history and teaching some of the history, to sit and listen to some of these other experts, or not other experts, because that implies I'm one, but these other people who really are experts on it. And it really is something we forget, that we're living, many of the people of Falls Township are living in really a historic site. And the founding, this creation of Levittown, really changed the way houses are built in America, still to this day, changed the way communities are planned in America, and really is something that, again, even around the world, it's sort of studied in terms of its impact and its on the nation and on the people who live there. So, again, the date's 23rd and 24th of June. It's open to anybody who wants to come. There's a website, www.levittowners.com, which is looking for people who want to volunteer their time or want to find out more information. It looks to be a great event. So anybody who's interested in that, again, www.levittowners.com, June 23rd, 24th. So. And I think at a future meeting, I know I talked to the gentleman who's organizing this today, and he was interested in seeing if we could do a proclamation honoring the 60th anniversary, which, of course, I think we'd be proud to do. And so we'll do that at a future meeting, maybe one of the meetings in June, so it's a little closer to the date, but we'll certainly be happy to do that. And with that, I thank the administration, the staff here, as well as the professionals for all their hard work. Very successful meeting. I know that... the most common complaint I get from people now in the township is that the meetings are too boring. I apologize for that, it doesn't mean we're not doing some good things here. I think we're taking some positive steps toward economic development, recognizing some great citizens, improving our police department, obviously taking steps necessary to maintain the high quality of the Pinewood Pool. All of that happened this evening, and so we'll continue to do those good works. As long as we're up here. So with that, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Seconding.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you.